Coming up next, it's Sessions at West 54th, hosted by John Hiatt. Tonight, it's the powerful words and thunderous music of the Mighty Rollins Band. Up next on Sessions at West 54th, made possible by...
He's belligerent, outspoken, and willful. He's armed with a barrage of facts and figures and a set of personal ethics that may leave you feeling foolish and morally bankrupt. But there's a whole lot of life and experience behind every word and gesture of Henry Rollins. And he's also got a generous spirit, a level of tolerance that's off the chart, and a heart the size of his record collection. His work with the seminal LA band Black Flag was only the beginning. He's gone on to travel the world, become a successful novelist, diarist, and stand-up poet, while always keeping his feet firmly planted in the music world he loves. The Rollins Band has a new lineup after 10 years, and if it sounds more like straight-ahead rock and roll, that's because it is. It's just the way the man wants it to be. Won't you please welcome the Rollins Band.
Hey, what's so unkind? Illumination. Illumination. normal again. Suffocation mind. Got a hammer in your hand. You've got the look in your eye, but do you have what it takes? You gotta ask yourself. Can you kill me as you confront yourself? The hammer becomes so heavy. Your eyes are mine. Now you see me. It's one thing to hold a hammer in your hand, but do you have it in you to pound the nail? So many of you line up, but so few of you cross the line. Talk is talk, kill is kill. Oh yeah! We'll be right back.
greatest need. I've got a thoughtless mind. I've got a needless want. I can't unwind. I've got a
thank you very much.
You want to talk about your new album?
Sure. We wanted to make a good hard rocking album. You know, it's not rocket science what we do. I see a real tepid kind of cookie cutter pop thing going on. And, you know, I've been listening to records since I can remember. My mom always had a lot of records around the house. So I got a taste for music, you know, good music.
Let's go back to, I guess, 1981, and when Black Flag burst on the scene. I was living out in L.A., and I remember you guys, you know, being
Flag was, a great band. And they were around before I was. They were having auditions for singers up here in New York. So I took a train up to New York, and I said, let me at it. And I sang two sets with them, just improvising, because they didn't have any real records out at that time. So I just kind of made up words. And they said, you're in. And a few days later, I caught up with them via Greyhound bus in Detroit with a duffel bag, and I gave away most of my possessions. Here's my bed, here's my desk. I gave my car to my roommate. I went for it, and all of a sudden I'm living in Los Angeles, broke, after having a job like all my life. I had my own apartment, my own car. I worked at a Haagen-Dazs. You get out to LA and you're in a starving band. First off, it's a new orientation to what hard work is. You're like, what do you mean there's no food in here?
Right.
I just worked, I put up flyers for 14 hours yesterday. There's no dinner? And then I just started doing more of the hanging out at burger places. Like, you're the guy in Black Flag. Yes, please feed me. All right, you know. Get those UCLA kids on their way into town slumming it in Hollywood. They'd always feed you.
Starving for your art.
And it was no problem because the music was so good. We were booking shows with everyone from real agents, like, you know, someone like Delsner here in New York, or Bill Graham in California, who was a godsend to us because he gave us respect. But then a lot of times in the Midwest, you're booking a show with a kid who has access to a Knights of Columbus Hall, he hopes.
Right.
And you'd get to these gigs and be like, and this old codger would come out of the Knights of Columbus Hall. Who are you, the Black Flags? Who is this kid with this haircut telling me there's a show in here tonight? We know nothing about this, and you're not putting on a show over my dead body. And all of a sudden, there's a sheriff going, like, everyone out of the van, everyone up against it. And you're like, oh, man. The kid's like, I'm sorry. And he's like 16. He just wanted to see the band play. And you're like, oh, man.
You are an international sensation. Oh, I see. Woo-hoo! Yeah.
Thank you very much.
How about writing? Have you been writing any?
Yeah.
I know you've published books. You have a publishing company.
Yeah, I have a publishing company. I've put out 12 books of my own and a bunch of other books, poetry, photo books, novels, short story collections, anthologies, and whatnot.
You did an audio book of Get in the Van.
Yeah.
Which won a Grammy.
Yeah.
That's pretty great.
I won a Grammy. We performed on the Grammys that time around. So we all went out in tuxes and did a song, and we got to sit, you know, with the other performers.
Right.
And, you know, it was fun. I went out there and tried to kick it like Bill Murray used to do his lounge singer thing, and I was blowing Springsteen's Mother's Kisses. I was like, and she's like, look, has this look on her face, like, who is this thing? When I got the Grammy, they said my name, and I went up. And I just come from soundcheck, from doing it for the show that night. So I'm in this sweated out shirt, a performer's laminate, and gym shorts. And I walk up there, and the security guys block my way, like, who's this lunatic? They have a tray of blank Grammys, so you hold it, and they 800 people take your photo. And I grabbed the Grammy, I said, it's funny, a bunch of people who look like you looking at a guy like me holding something like this. I bet you're confused, huh? And everyone's like, who are you? I said, all right, well, thanks. I was like, yeah, get him out of here. But it was cool. I gave it to my manager. In my place, it looked like stolen property. Everywhere I put it, it looked out of place.
Get some, go again. Tell me that you got none left. Inspiration, don't you tell me that you got none left. I like it when it's over and another one's begun. I like it when it's over and another one's begun. Look at my watch and it always is the time to go.
You're watching Sessions at West 54th, hosted by John Hyatt.